Hi everyone, and welcome to another episode of PILOTCLIMB.com. I'm Gabriele, and I'm training captain on the Boeing 737, and I help you to become a better pilot. Today's video is the part 2 of a series of 3 videos where we're gonna perform a full flight. My idea was to make a full flight in one video, but then I just found out that it was way too long. So I'm gonna divide the video of the full flight into 3 videos. The first part, we went from the cold and dark setup of the aircraft. Okay, basically the aircraft, as you find out when you get on board, okay, after an overnight, for example, all the way up to almost the cruise. Okay, in this video, in this part 2, we're gonna go into the cruise. Okay, we're gonna fly the cruise. We're gonna get ready for the approach. Okay, so what we're gonna do in this video, I'm gonna tell you what we normally you should do during cruise, and then on top of that, we're gonna prepare the aircraft for the approach. So we're gonna brief the chart. We're gonna make a lot of the consideration that you should make when performing the approach, okay, when performing the briefing for your approach. Okay, so without further ado, let's jump right into it. So at the moment, first of all, I strongly recommend to see and watch the first video, okay, because the first video we talked about where we were, what we're doing, and what was the plan, okay. But very quickly, we took off from Bergamo, and we are going to Palma di Mallorca. Bergamo is in north of Italy, Palma di Mallorca is an island in Spain, okay. So now we are cruising at flight level 350, as you can see, okay, and we are approaching France, okay, the France airspace. If I do something like that, I can actually show you where we are. Alright, so if I go like that, and like that, beautiful, then I go, here we go. So as you can see, the aircraft there in the screen, okay, that's the aircraft, and we've got, okay, we are already into France now, okay, and we are going inbound Palma de Mallorca, okay. We've got 213 miles to the top of descent, as you can, as you can see in there, we've got 212 miles to the top of descent. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna start and make the full preparation for the approach. Okay, so I'm gonna prepare the aircraft as I've been doing for the last 10 years in my career, okay? Again, it is very important that if you have any questions throughout the preparation and the video of today, leave a comment below and then I will help you out, okay? So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna tell you that I'm not very familiar with this simulation. Okay, with this flight simulator here, okay, this is the prep part 3D, so sometimes I may be a little bit slow to find out where find the information about the simulator, not the aircraft, because I'm quite familiar with the aircraft, but sometimes the simulator has got some sub menus that you should click in order to find out information. And if I'm a little bit slow, please be kind with me, okay? So the first thing that I always recommend to do once you get to your cruise level is to do a cross check, a full check of the aircraft switches, okay? In this case, on the Boeing 737, what would you do? Normally, would you start from the overhead, okay? And you cross check that all the switches are in the position that they should be, okay? Sometimes you might forget some switches somewhere, okay? So once you get to the cruise, you've got a bit of time, you know, you want to make sure that everything is in place, okay? You want to make sure, like, that all the switches basically are in place, because sometimes it might happen that you forget something, okay? So now, during cruise as well, you should be aware of your FIR boundaries, okay? Because once you reach, for example, we took off from Italy, then we reached the limit between Italy and France FIR, okay? In that, when you reach that limit, they basically ask you to contact France, okay? So maybe Paris or whatever. So make sure that you know where you are, and make sure that you are aware of your FIR limits, okay? Because if you don't contact the new ATC unit and you go into their airspace, if you don't contact them for a long period of time, normally it's half an hour, you enter the airspace, you are a little bit in troubles, okay? That's why it's a good practice if you have 2 COM radios, okay? One, in the COM radio number 2, the one that you basically don't use or you use it on standby, you set 1:1.5, because the ATC will call you on this frequency if they cannot reach you on the frequency, in the primary frequency, okay? In the COM number 1, for example, you want to have the ATC that you are flying in, okay? So now we are in France, let's say Paris ATC, okay? And the COM 2, okay, you want to have 1:1.5 on a lower volume. So if they cannot contact you on the 1, they're going to contact you on the 2, use the 1:1.5. Okay, beautiful. So now let's start the preparation. Again, as everything, okay, when you start the preparation of your flight, it is imperative that you have a good structure. Okay, make up your own or study the structure of your company. But anyway, the most important thing is not what structure you use, is to have a structure. Okay, I hope I won't forget anything today in this video, because again, using the flight simulator is a little bit strange for me at the moment, because I'm still getting used to this simulation, okay, using the mouse, using the keyboard and stuff like that, and on top of that, I'm completely alone. Okay, in real life, you fly two people, you are in there, the pilots and the multi-pilot aircraft, you are in two because you help, you know, you help your colleague helps you, so if you forget something, then you, the colleague will help you out. But here, I'm not familiar with the simulation, okay, so I may be missing out something because of that, and on top of that, I'm alone. So I'm a little bit prone to, more prone to do some mistakes, okay, but anyway, we'll try and see what happened, okay. So, first of all, when you prepare your aircraft, you want to start by setting up your FMC, because at the end of the day, if you're gonna fly the aircraft with the LNAV and VNAV like we are doing now, you want to make sure that the points and the information that the FMC has is correct. Okay, so first of all, you want to set up your descent phase. Okay, so what I can suggest you to use as a structure, use the structure as you're flying. So first of all, you're gonna descend, okay, so you're gonna take care of the descent, so you need to set up the winds for your VNAV to calculate the VNAV path. You want to set up your star, your standard arrival. You want to set up your approach, okay, so your ILS, okay. Then after you do the approach, you're actually landing, so what you need to do to calculate the landing performances, and then once you land, you do the taxi, so you want to actually take care of the taxi, okay. So a good structure is just to follow the flow of your flight, okay, so you're not gonna jump to the landing phase before you actually took care of the descent management, okay, descent preparation. All right, so let's start. I'm gonna make the FMC bigger in order to make it easier. So first of all, we want to change this speed restriction there on the descent page. Okay, this is the descent page, and there's 240 below flight level 100, but we can actually fly 250 below flight level 100. On the forecast page, you should set your QNH in there, and then if you have any winds from the OFP, okay, and then the OFP, on the OFP, on the lead of flight plan, you can actually find the descent winds, and you want to put them in here, okay? Normally, if you put the winds every 10,000 feet, should be more than enough, okay? What happens if you put the winds in there is because with the tailwind, the VNAV will give you, will prepare your descent according to that, or with the headwind, okay? I made a separate video where I talked about the VNAV and how it does calculate your descent. Go and watch that, okay? Alright, so, but because in this video the wind is pretty much calm, as we briefed already, there is no wind, the wind should be in here, okay? So as you can see, it's wind calm, I'm not gonna put the winds in there, okay? Beautiful. So, now let's go into the route phase, okay? So now, in the first video we talked about, I had a problem with the chart, because the chart was not matching the route, okay, but now I found out a problem, because I had an old chart, okay. Now I just come up with an updated chart, and the new charts are actually a temporary chart. So according to our flight plan, we should have flown a specific let me put this one big as well, so we can actually see it better. So according to our flight plan, our route, let me see if it's here we go. So our route should have been like this, okay? So as you can see, this is the route, okay? So as you can see, that's what we're doing, and from Lunik, the arrival phase, Lunik, that's our star, Lunik 2 Mike, inbound Palma Mallorca 06 left. However, the Lunik 2 Mike is not there anymore. We've got the Lunik 3 Mike, okay? So the problem is that the FMD OFP that I did from simbrief.com didn't have the Lunik 3 mic in there. So we're gonna say ILS 06 left, but we're gonna say the Lunik 3 mic in there, okay? And then we try to do the Charlie Delta Papa transition, okay? We execute that, and now we see what happened in there. Beautiful. So Lunik 3 mic, Mike Juliet Victor, okay? And then we've got a route discontinuity in there, then Charlie Delta Pop, and then the whole thing. Let me see if the ILS 06 left has got... No, this is the only one, Charlie Delta Pop. Well, we tried to fix it, okay? So now, let's go into the charts, into the actual charts, okay? And trying to figure it out what we've got to do. So, the first thing that we need to check is that we've got the Lunik 3 mic in there. Is we've got all the points that are correct. Okay, how do we know? How do we do this check? Basically, if you go in here, you go into plan mode. Okay, as you can see here, it says centered. If I click step, it's gonna move to the next point. So what we're gonna do? We're gonna check point by point. Okay. On our Lunik arrival, okay, Lunik standard arrival, and we make sure that the points are actually the same of the chart. Cool, so let me see. That's the chart in here. Here we go. So, Lunik 3 mic, Lunik 3 mic. So, as we said again, let's use a structure when doing the when reading the chart from the top to the bottom, left to right. So these are the frequency. 119 decimal 255 is the 80s, and that is the one that you want to use to get the latest weather information in Palma de Mallorca. However, in this simulator, I don't know why it's not working the 80s yet. I'm trying to figure out the reason why. So we said we've got some notes in here. We should read all of them. Okay, final approach frequency change, initial call to Palma final 118 decimal 955 should be restricted to call sign only, in order to avoid frequency congestions. Okay, so because when it's busy, you don't want to talk too much in the radius, okay? Then set speed 250 at flight level 100 or where crossing speed limit point, SLP, whichever came first, okay? 210 knots at 12 DME ILS, 190/9, 160/4, and that's it. Or ILS equivalent distance from threshold in case the DME ILS is unserviceable. If unable to comply, notify ATC. There will be no ATC, so we try to comply with those, okay? Wait for radar vectors before it. Okay, that's not a big deal because we're not gonna have any ATC today. Do not proceed beyond the initial approach fix unless cleared by ATC without ATC clearance, okay? Incorporate to the holding pattern. Okay, fantastic. So what they are saying that if you don't get any clearance from the ATC, we should stop at the initial approach fix of our procedure. Okay, for us it's gonna be Mike, Julia, Victor, that one in there. Okay, so let's check out the points. Okay, so if you come in here, that's gonna be our procedure. Okay, starts from Lunik, goes all the way down to Charlie Delta Papa, then is a right turn and we're going to the Mike, Julia, Victor. Okay, so let's see what we've got in here in our FMC. So Lunik point is in there. Here we go. So we've got Lunik. And then we have an altitude restriction of 3,000 feet or above, if you call in our, as well in a flight level 100, okay? Beautiful. So then we've got 176 for 45 nautical miles, pretty much, to Charlie Delta Papa. And we've got here 177, 45 nautical miles. Beautiful. And we have an altitude restriction of 5,000 feet throughout this segment in here, all the way down to Charlie Delta Papa. It's okay, because we're going to be, well, that's not correct. This is the altitude that we're gonna be at Charlie Delta Papa. That's completely wrong for sure, because we're not gonna be there at 315. Since we are very close to the runway already there, we cannot cross at 31,000 feet there. So we put 5,000 feet or above as the restriction is in here, and we execute that. Beautiful. Then it says right turn. Okay, right turn onto the 242. You can see here, Charlie Delta Papa, right turn. 243 in this case, 4,000 feet above, 10 nautical miles. So 242, 10 miles, and we've got 4,000 feet or above. Here we go. I put it in there. Okay. So then, same track, another 25 nautical miles to Mike, Julia, Victor. Same track, 25 nautical miles, Mike, Julia, Victor. We have an altitude restriction in there of 4,000 feet, as you can see in here. So I take another 40 or above, and I put it in there. Okay. The A means or above. That means that we can fly above 4,000 at that point, but not below that. Okay, so then from there we should go into our approach charts. Beautiful. So actually our approach charts, we should have this one, because okay, let me see. Yeah, what we're gonna do actually, because we've got as you can see in the previous arrival, we have the Charlie Delta Papa. Okay, so we arrived at Charlie Delta Papa, and then we made the check on the points. However, even this approach chart can start from Charlie Delta Papa. Okay, because actually, in order to be 100% correct, since we are flying the Lunik 3 mic that's gonna go all the way down to Mike, Julia, Victor, which is this point in there, we should actually use the ILS run is 06 left, but with the Mike, Julia, Victor transition. Okay, so from here we should turn right. However, The problem is that if I go in here and I go in there, there is no Mike Giulio transition in there. So what I'm gonna do instead, we're gonna actually fly the Lunik 3 Mike all the way down to the Charlie Delta Papa. Let me see. Here we go. So yeah, we're gonna fly the Lunik 3 Mike all the way down to Charlie Delta Papa, and then from there we join the ILS, okay? Because then the ILS start from Charlie Delta Papa, and we fly all of these, okay? So these are the points of the Charlie Delta Papa. Okie dokie. So I take those points in there, and then I connect that. Oh, sorry. My. There we go. So I can do like that. Okay. So now we have a VNAV disconnect message. Not a big deal. So as you can see, we are still in altitude hold. The aircraft is descending. And then I press level change, and I ask the autopilot to climb back to the 350. So it should work now. Let's see if VNAV works again. No, it doesn't. Okay. So now we are back at 350, and I try to engage again VNAV. That's a strange thing, because you should not do something like that. Anyway, let me see. So we've got Lunik, that actually tap up and then the approach. Fantastic. So now, I don't know why this is not working. VNAV should work now. Let me see. Yeah? Let me try to do something in here. If I press that, and then I go back in VNAV, doesn't work. Okay. So let me try to do something like this. Let me try to climb flight level 360, engage VNAV, see if it works. No, it doesn't. Okay, it's very weird, because since I changed the arrival, the procedure, VNAV get disconnected, and it doesn't want to reconnect. Okay, that's not a big deal. Let's try to re-put the Charlie Delta Papa transition in and see if it works. I take the Charlie Delta Papa point, and then I put the Charlie Delta Papa point. Let me put the arrival again. Is the Lunik 3 Mike. Lunik 3 Mike. ILS 06 Charlie Delta Papa transition, as we said before. Now we should have the route discontinuity, because it goes all the way down to the Mike Juliet Victor, as we briefed. However, I changed that one to that one, and VNAV should work now. Beautiful. Yes, so guys, as you can see, I haven't changed basically anything. The only thing I did, I just re-put the points in there. Sometimes this actually happens in real life. Something strange happens, you don't know what. Try to reload the FMC, try to switch on, switch off the system, and it should work, okay? Alright, so now, let's do the Palma de Mallorca ILS 06 left chart. Okay, these are the frequency. Again, the 80s we discussed. We've got ILS DME 110.9 Palma de Mallorca, Papa Lima Mike. Beautiful. So let's set this on the NAV. So 110.9 is in here. Very good. 110.9 is in there. Okay, okay. So that's set. And final approach track 058. The final approach track, you should go in here and set it in here. And go like this. And 058 on the final approach course in there as well. Beautiful. Then we've got transition elevation, threshold elevation 15 feet, aerodrome elevation 27 feet, and in here we've got 0 feet. Transition altitude 6000, threshold level by ATC, okay? So transition altitude 6000, let's call transition level 70 for today, since there will be no ATC. Okay, so now what we've got in here, the route. We've got a lot of notes in here, okay? So VOR and DME is required, missed approach con fail is not applicable to for us today. Speed is the restrictions we briefed already. Then we've got in here temporary procedures, that's okay. Then we've got the VOR, then we have these notes in here, ADF, okay, required, that's not a big deal. Beautiful. So let's check out that the route is actually correct from Charlie Delta Papa. I take the FMC back again and the navigation display in here, and we go point by point, okay? So, Charlie Delta Papa, we should be 3,000 feet or above, on track 243, 35 nautical miles to Mike Juliet Victor. And actually, it's not really the same, because this guy goes all the way down to the Charlie Delta Papa 41, this point in there. Okay, yes, because the Mike Juliet Victor is for this the other transition. Or otherwise, it goes all the way down to Charlie Delta Papa 41, Charlie Delta Papa 41, 3,000 feet or above, 250 knots maximum. I can actually go 250 or below in here on the speed, okay? Because in this case, if the VNAV wants to decelerate, okay, that's okay for him. Then it's a right turn, okay, onto the Boeing Charlie Delta Papa 43. So let's see where that point is. So that's 13 miles arc, which is not in the box in here. Okay, beautiful. So what happened is that instead of flying the arc, it's actually creating a point in here, and then it's gonna go like on a straight line to this point in there, Delta 229, which is the living radial basically. It's a little bit weird because it should do an arc. An arc DME arc starts from Juliet Oscar Alpha. It's a 13 DME arc Juliet Oscar Alpha. What we can do to see if we are actually complying with that arc, if we put the Juliet Oscar Alpha on the fixed page and we do the 13 nautical miles ring, okay, we can see that we are actually gonna fly pretty close to the 13 nautical miles arc. Okay, so I'm gonna keep this one in order to make sure that we actually fly the 13 nautical miles arc as required on the FMC, sorry, on the procedures. Okay, so that's the point in there, and then we continue, we go on to the radial, leaving radial 229, this one where you can turn right, intercept, and follow the localizer. So that's the 229 radial in there. Okay, then from there we turn right and we can actually intercept the localizer where we can be at 1,100 feet or above. Beautiful. So then at Fox.06 left, we go 1,700 feet or above, which is the seven nautical miles point, which should be that one in there. Okay, Juliet Oscar Alpha, here we go. So yes, it's 5 miles from the runway and it's 5.1 nautical miles. Yes, makes sense. How do I know that it's 5 nautical miles from the runway? It's because this point in here is in the center. Okay, sorry, we just cross. Here we go. Because this point in here is in the center and this ring is 5 nautical miles. So as you can see, are the 5 nautical miles we've got around in there. Okay, so beautiful. Then we've got from there, we can actually descend, and in case of go around, it's going to be climb direct to Juliet Oscar Alpha. All right, this is the Juliet Oscar Alpha in there. Okay, 117.7, turn left, maximum 185. So in case of go around, it's going to be Juliet Oscar Alpha. All right, so maximum 185 knots, which is in there. Then is a turn left on radial 026 Juliet Oscar Alpha to 7.5 nautical miles. 026 Juliet Oscar Alpha 8 nautical miles. And then we've got at 3,000 feet, turn right, maximum 210 knots to intercept for radial 268. So we've got, here we go. That's the point in there. And then what we've got at 3 nautical miles, turn right, intercept the radial 268. Beautiful. So the 268 radial is the 088. So it's this one. Okay. So 088 track is in there as well. So that's what it's going to do. It's going to turn right, intercept the radial 088 at 3,000 feet. We don't have here the point 3,000 feet, but we're going to do it ourselves by ourselves. So that's the VOR in there somewhere. Charlie Delta Papa. Here we go. Yes, Charlie Delta Papa is in there. Okay. So beautiful. We've got the missile approaches in there. So basically, straight ahead, Juliet Oscar Alpha left turn to intercept and follow the radial 026, okay, to 7.5 nautical miles. Juliet Oscar Alpha then is at 3,000 feet turn right. So it's not a big deal, okay? As you said, they follow the radial 268 in bound Charlie Delta Papa. For the frequencies, in case of go around, I'm going to set up the Juliet Oscar Alpha 117.7. on the standby here, 117.7, and the other frequency I'm gonna set up the Charlie Delta Papa, which is 12.9. Beautiful. So in case of ground, we've got these two frequencies that we will be required. Okay, the missed approach altitude is going to be, in our case, 3,000 feet, and I can put 3,000 feet in here as well. Invalid entry. Beautiful. There we go. So 3,000 feet is in there. Cool. So now we can go down and we can actually read. We've got difference minima depending on your ILS missed approach claim gradient. Okay. The missed approach claim gradient 5% we've got for our category, which is Charlie 309 feet. However, there is not a big rush. Okay. It's a nice day. We can actually use the 2.5 missed approach claim gradient. Minima will be 1269. Okay. So I said that 1269, which is quite high minima. Okay. it's very, very high minimum. But since the weather is fine, there should be no problem. 1269. Here we go. So 1269 is in there. Beautiful. So circuit minimum is not required for us. We've got the landing distance available 3270, 45 meters is white, and we've got puppy left and right 3 degrees. Okie dokie, so we checked everything that is correct, and now what we can actually do, I can actually do something like this as well. 06 left, here we go. So I can put the 10 nautical miles in there just to as a situational awareness. Okay, beautiful. So now what we can actually do, we can calculate some performance for landing. Okay, so let me see in here. EML, weight and balance. I don't know. Want to go to the landing. To the landing, weight and balance. Where is the landing? Menu, performances. Calculating, show ATM, CDL. Show landing, here we go. Fantastic, so airports. We've got Lima, Echo, Papa, Alpha. Search item. Runway 07 left, which is in there. Conditions dry. Wind, it was 330 at, let me see. Oops, sorry. So documents, and let's check out the winds in there. Okay, the wind for Palma de Mallorca is 060 at 3 knots. Okay. So 060/3. Temperature, again, what was the temperature there? 15 degrees, okay. So guys, I'm using this one because I don't know how the ATIS works in this simulator, okay? So 15 degrees, QNH was quite high, 1035, if I'm not wrong. Which one I put in there? Yes, 1035. Great. So flap, let's check with flap 30, air conditioning on, anti-ice off, calculate. Cool, there is not a big deal. Well, these are calculated in pounds, okay? So what is saying us that, but this is for the dispatching. Oops, sorry, I did a mistake because I just calculated the dispatch, okay? So this is the en route, this is the one that you should use when you actually fly, because you can actually calculate the dispatching landing performance and the en route landing performance, okay? The dispatch landing performance must be calculated before the flights to make sure that you can actually land in there safely. And once you take off, you should use the en route landing performances, okay? So at the moment, we're gonna land there with 3.5, and now we have 4.1. So this is 600 kilograms of fuel in difference, and that is 60. It's gonna give us a landing weight of 64.6. No, it's 600 kilograms of difference, right? Yeah. So 600 kilograms of difference, 64.4. 64.4 in pounds. Now let me calculate that again. 64.4. All right, 64,400 kilograms is 41, let's call it 42,000 pounds, okay? So weight, show keyboard, 14, here we go, 142. Calculate. Okay, so we've got in here, all operative, the reverse thrust, flap 30, air conditioning on, anti-ice off, brakes. Let's use the auto brake 3. Not normal, known. Okay, complete. So let's calculate and see what it says. Beautiful. So speed 152, and we've got a landing distance required of 5,334 meters. Landing distance available 9,400. So we're gonna stop pretty much at the half of the runway. Okay. So now I can use actually flap 30 in there. Beautiful. And auto brake 3. So I come in here and I set up the auto brake 3. Cool. That's awesome. So every time you are briefing, actually, you want to make sure that you cross-check the distance to the top of the descent. As you can see, we are getting close to the top of the descent, only 13 miles. Okay. So as we said yesterday, the plan for the next video is going to actually to fly the plan for the next video is going to be to actually fly the descent. Okay. So we're going to talk about descent management. What happened if you get high or if you get low? What happened with the VNAV? We're going to change VNAV to level change in vertical speed. We're going to look at all of these different descent modes. Okay, so if you have any question, leave a comment below and then I will help you out. Okay, if you had any question throughout the video, okay, if you really want to support the channel, give it a like. The last thing that we're gonna talk about in this video before actually stopping is the fuel. Okay, we've got at the moment 4 tons, okay, and we're gonna land there with 3.5. okay, according to our flight plan, I can actually let me see. No, I can according to our flight plan, okay, if I came in here and then table of contents, I came in here and there, and I can actually find out, here we go. According to our flight plan, the alternate is Barcelona, and the fuel, the reserve fuel that we need is this, the sum of these two. Okay, so alternate Barcelona 1.5, final reserve fuel 1.1, so 2.6 is our final reserve, and we're gonna land in Palma de Mallorca with 3.5, so it's around 1 ton extra of fuel. Okay, so 1 ton extra of fuel is gonna give us pretty much around 20 minutes of holding available. Okay, because if you take your fuel flow in here, at the moment we are burning 0.8, and 0.8 is 1600 kilograms of fuel. Okay, so you wanna keep around 2300-2400 kilograms of fuel. So now, as you can see in here, we've got reset. Oops, sorry, I don't know how I did this. Let me see, close window, maybe. Yes, fantastic. So as you can see in here, we've got this reset MCP altitude message on the FMC. Why we got this message is because we reached the top of the descent point. Okay, as you can see in here, we've got this DD green. That means that the VNAV, after taking into consideration all the information that we set in the FMC, actually calculate the top of descent. The top of descent is the point where the VNAV wants to start descent. So once you reach, once you get close to the top of descent, exactly 5 nautical miles prior to the top of descent, the message on the FMC, reset MCP altitude, show up to tell you that you should actually start to do something about your descent, otherwise you're gonna be high. Okay, the next thing that we're gonna do in the next video, we're gonna lower the altitudes on the MCP in here, okay, and then start our descent in Palma de Mallorca. But that is the content for the next video. Okay, so again guys, if you have any question, leave a comment below and I will help you out. Support the channel, give it a like, share this video, and consider subscribing to the channel. I wish you a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.